running right on time. Our next speaker is Josh Grams. Take it away, Josh.
All right. So I've always liked spaceflight in games, those mechanics of managing your momentum and the classic Asteroids dilemma of wanting to face this way to shoot the enemy and that way to avoid getting hit by a rock. But these games often aren't approachable. You know, they tend to drop you right in the action with, you know, little opportunity to experiment and get comfortable. You know, it's a weird sort of motion that you don't have any real life reference for, and sometimes they're just too fast. And, you know, you can modify the mechanics, but those tend to backfire, right? If you enforce a top speed, then your spaceship drives more like a car, but then people tend to just want to drive fast all the time and not really engage with them. So I've wondered for years, could you make a turn-based space game, you know, where you keep the neat bits, but, you know, people could stop and think when they get overwhelmed. So for the 2018 7-day roguelike, I prototyped this about 20 hours, and then I kept coming back to it for almost a year, totaling about 100 hours. I was being kind of a smartass about the Berlin interpretation, so I used ASCII characters on a grid, but rotating ASCII characters on a hex grid. Partly I just like hex grids, and partly they give you more directions than four without the problem of some of them being longer than others. It uses pretty standard Asteroids mechanics, you know, turn and accelerate, three bullets on screen at once, one hit and you're dead. Where are we at? How do you show your velocity? With whole grid cells, you know, your speed would have to range from, oh, you move one cell every three turns to you move, you know, three cells every turn. So I subdivided the grid and made this diamond grid that it takes four steps to go from one hex to the next. What else? I made these shadows that go ahead of you to show where you're going to move. And first I made this line of shadows and they look kind of cool, but they also look like they should be trailing behind you. And a lot of people, I found out much later, thought that each shadow was a turn instead of the whole line of shadows being a single turn. Now, in a real-time game, you know, you can obviously turn and accelerate and shoot all at the same time. But in turn-based, that's kind of a UX nightmare. Like, how do you tell the game if you're going to turn or accelerate or shoot or all three? How do you cancel just one part of that motion? You know, do you have to confirm the turn to make it go? You know, that makes it feel slow and we want it to be snappy. So I just gave each direction a key, and you just tap the key and you can turn from any direction to that direction and it just takes a turn. What else? But then rotating, if you only rotate one step at a time, then that's super expensive. You know, it takes three turns to turn all the way around. I threw in this random walk dungeon generator. You know, you stamp out a room, you turn to a random exit, you repeat. Occasionally you split off another walker. You know, it creates all your floor tiles. You know they're connected. You know, it creates sort of more organic shapes than some of the other algorithms. And it's pretty easy to drastically change the character of the space by changing how you choose the rooms and the exits, although I didn't do a lot with that here. There are only two enemies in the game. The one is these turrets that rotate to face you, and then occasionally they shoot. The other is an acid jelly that when you shoot it, it splits into two smaller jellies and they kill you on contact. And they just accelerate towards you occasionally. And I thought, you know, they don't steer very well. Maybe eight would be a good number to start with. And they were just terrifying. Like, you know, they just kind of converge on you. I mean, this is me having played the game for 2 years. And then you shoot them and the little ones explode in all directions. So I pretty quickly backed off the numbers and I made them only steer like every five turns and I cut their sight range almost in half. And then I added some money to pick up and that was the 7-day version. It was, you know, it was all right. But the thing that struck me when I was writing this talk was that like how little each of the individual changes I made was. So version two, I added the story about, I renamed it to the Yam of Endor, and there's a story about, you know, the search for this legendary root vegetable. So I replaced the money with this orange food and I put the yam at the bottom. Version two, my original version had all the keys on my left hand because I like games that you can play one-handed while you're eating a sandwich with the other hand, but you know, left hand is most people's offhand and it was just kind of too complicated. Yeah, and then I had some friends playtest it and tweaks the level generation because it was way too hard, of course. I changed the color of the walls to make them more visible. I added the circle to show your shield. There are sight lines here, which are probably pretty much invisible. And there's ridiculous screen shake, which is always good, right? Also, the level generation starts you on the stairs, and my second try at the control is to use the W key to grab an item or use the stairs to the next level. And yeah, it turns out that if you hit W right off the bat, it gives you this losing message. And, you know, turns out that that's a pretty bad thing to do to a new player who's, you know, just trying to accelerate with WASD. Especially if that's Jupiter Hadley playing all the games. So that was, I ended up disabling the original exit stairs just to make sure that you couldn't like lose the game off the bat. So you have to wait until you leave the level and come back. Version 4 was mostly UI. I added mouse over tooltips for the enemies and the items. I added this in-game like control help. And then the last two versions were gamepad support. So I made this nifty little overlay to show where you're pointing the stick and when it's going to trigger you to turn. At first I thought you tap the key in the direction to aim that direction, and that's perfect. You just point the stick, but you hold the stick. So if you wiggle it a little bit, sometimes you'll turn by mistake, and that'll cost you a turn. And didn't work well. I combined consecutive aiming turns. So like if you aim and aim and aim again, it only takes a single turn, and that helped, but not enough. So I kind of floundered there for a while until my cousin suggested just having a move button that would accelerate if you were pointing the stick forward and turn if you were pointing some other direction and coast if you weren't holding it at all. And that worked much better. It simplified the controls to the point where I could just have just the face buttons and the stick. Yeah, that's pretty much where it stands. And, you know, it's still a jam game. It's still probably a little hard. It's kind of weird. There's not much there, but it was a really neat experiment. And it's really fun watching people make the exact same mistakes that they do in a real-time space game. So they'll start off and they'll just accelerate way too fast, and then they won't be able to stop and they'll crash into a wall. Or they'll get into a tight space and they'll just panic and they'll just start pounding the keys until they die. And it's really fun to be there and just be like, no, take your hands off the keyboard. Like, you can stop and think, and seeing that realization. I'd love to do a more in-depth take on this. You know, maybe something more adventure, less shooty, shooty, bang, bang. But I think, you know, if you've got one of these improbable ideas that's been brewing in the back of your head for a year or three, like, you know, I think they're worth prototyping. I mean, worst case, you find out that the idea doesn't have legs, but usually you find something about why, you know? And, you know, best case, you might come up with something really cool. So yeah, that's me. Thanks for listening.
Thank you so much. That was super cool. That game looks great.
Thank you.
Wow, I really want to play it. I love the idea of having sort of a turn-based space game.